Hi friends, welcome to Taming Python series. In this video, we're going to talk about multiple plots in the same subplot using matplotlib. So at the end of this video, you're going to learn how to create multiple line plots in a single subplot, something like this. If you do not know about the basics of matplotlib plotting or how to style matplotlib plots, I've created videos on those and I'll leave the link of those videos in the description of this video, and I recommend you to check that out if you don't know. Let's take a blank folder. I'm going to open it with VS Code. All right, my VS Code is open now. I'm going to create a new file. I'm just going to name it index.py. First, I'm going to import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. So basically what I'm doing is I'm aliasing this submodule of matplotlib as plt. First, let me try to create some data to plot. So for the first line plot, I want to create two arrays called x1, y1. And the second, for the second line plot, I want to create two arrays, something like x2 and y2. So I'm going to copy paste the data from my example in this blog post. So the first x data is something like this. So now I've got the data, right? X and y and x and y of the two line plots. So let me try to create a canvas on which we can plot the figures. So basically figure comma axis handle equal to plt dot subplots. So basically what it does is basically it will create a canvas for plotting, and in return it will give a figure handle and an axis handle. So we can use this axis handle to create a line plot. So how can you do that? You just write axis dot plot, and here you just give the x1 y1. So basically what you did is you gave data to plot on this axis handle, and then at the end you write plt dot show. That's all. So with three lines of code you can actually create a line plot in matplotlib. So if I just run this, you can see I've got a single line plot. Now let us see how can I create a multiple line plot in a single subplot. You just copy paste this line, and here you just write x2, y2, that's all. So basically what we are doing is I'm using the same axis handle and I'm calling the plot function again on that. So basically it will insert a new line plot into that. So if I just run this, you can see I've got two line plots in a single subplot. So this is what we are talking about. Use the axis handle and use the plot function on it again and again, and then you can insert multiple line plots or scatter plots or whatever into a single subplot. So this was mainly the essence of this video, guys. So use the single axis handle, and if you call the plot function on it again and again, you can insert multiple line plots into a single subplot. Okay, now let's try to style this a little bit. So first let me try to insert a title to this figure. So for that I'll just write ax dot set title, and I'll write axis title. I'll write something like multiple plots example. All right, so what I did was I set ax.set title, and now you can see I've got a new title to my axis, my figure. And now I want to set x and y axis labels to my figure. So I'll just write ax.set x label, and here I'm gonna give some label to the x-axis. So I'll write here x-axis data, and I want to give the y-axis label also. So I'll just write ax.set y label, and I'll write something like y-axis. So now let's try to run this and see how it looks like. You can see I've got the y-axis label and x-axis label also. Let's try to, you know, create a legend also for this. How can I do that? So, you know, while plotting the two line plots, you can get the line artist in return. So this LA1 is basically line artist. And here also, while plotting the second line plot, I'll just write LA2 comma equal to. So basically I'll get the line artist 2 also. So I've got the line artist of the first line plot and the second line plot. So I'll use this line artist to set the label for this plot. So I'll just write LA1 dot set label, and I'll write first plot, and for the second line artist I'll just write LA2 dot set label, I'll just write second, something like this. And at the end what I got to do is ax dot legend. So what this does is actually it creates a legend based upon these labels which I've set using this line artist. So now just by adding the labels and enabling the legend using this axis handle dot legend, I can actually add legends to my plot. So if I just run this, you can see I've got my legend here. You know, even I can add markers to my line plot. So if I want to add some marker to my second line plot, I'll just write after x and y marker equal to, if I want a circle marker, I'll write marker equal to O. So let me try to run this now. You can see I've got a circle marker on each data point in my line plot. All right. So if you want to change the color of the lines, it's just simple. You just write comma color equal to. If you want to change this color to red, I'll just write color equal to red. And for the line plot, first one, I want to set some hex color. It's also easy. Just write color equal to hash and you just give the color code. So if I write some fully red and partially green and very mild blue, let me see how it looks like. So I've given a hex code as a color for the first line plot, and second line plot I told color equal to red. So now using this, just these two settings, I can even change the color of the line plot. So let's see how it looks like. You can see I've changed the colors of both the line plots. So this is how you can add multiple line plots into a single subplot using matplotlib. You can see I've created a blog post on creating multiple plots in a single subplot using matplotlib. And in this blog post, I have even given examples so that you can copy paste and reproduce the figures which I have produced in this video so that you can practice yourself. I have even given the example of styled plot also so that you can add more styles to your multiple line plots. Hope you like this video, guys. Thank you for watching.